McCullough Punch, the socialist nut roots of America have not forced their candidate upon the Democratic Party for 2008. Not as of yet. That's what the process is all about in the primaries. But be that as it may, there's an emerging qualified vice presidential candidate that would be a handsome addition to Hillary, Obama, or Edwards, should any of them actually get the nomination. His name is Michael Vick. I've got four specific reasons why he would be the ideal Democratic running mate. One is name recognition. See, last year he started his PR campaign off by showing, shall we say, a unique form of appreciation to those who pay a lot of money to come see him play in his pro football games. Only problem is, the fans didn't feel as appreciative of his gesture as he felt of them. But that's not entirely uncommon. Democrats, for a long time, have just brushed off people that they don't agree with. There's a second reason why Vick would be so well embraced on the Democratic ticket. He very much could be the symbol, the spokesmodel, even the poster child for some of the policies. For instance, Barack Obama this week said that we should be teaching sex education to five-year-olds.
Remember Alan Keyes? I ran against Alan Keyes. I don't know if you guys remember Alan Keyes. But I remember him using this in a in his campaign against me, saying Barack Obama supports teaching sex education to kindergartners, and you know, which I didn't know what to tell him. but it's the right thing to do.
Well, had Michael Vick himself been the product of some form of sexual education at any time previous to 2005, he might have actually prevented being sued by a one-night stand named Sonia for passing his herpes on to her. But put that aside for a second. There's a third reason why he would appeal to the Democratic base. Because for the last 10 years, Jesse Jackson has been attempting to woo new voters to the rolls. Voters that one time had their voting privileges, but because they committed things like felonies, had their voting rights taken away. Yep, the Democratic attempt to get felons to be able to vote, well, Vick would be the poster child for that. He'd be the perfect example of someone who did wrong, but now could say he was on the right path. Finally, there may not be a better example of the moral authority that Democrats will take with them into the voting booth in the coming election cycle than Michael Vick. After all, his most recent kerfuffle with the press all stemmed from his raising dogs who like to tear each other limb from limb. That same week, we saw two 15-year-old girls get in trouble for lighting a kitten on fire. But when you really think about it, the Democrats don't really mind this too much. Oh, sure, Robert Byrd said he's going to burn in hell for it.
I am confident that the hottest places in hell are reserved for the souls of sick and brutal people who hold God's creatures in such brutal and cruel contempt.
But at the end of the day, what's the difference in lighting a kitten on fire or letting bulldogs scrap it out in a back alley brawl as to, say, washing children in acid or saline or ripping them limb for limb or stabbing them in the back of the head with a fork and suctioning their brains out? After all, Democrats didn't just tacitly approve of such measures, they fought for them, argued for them, and voted for them in repeated rounds of legislation. And when the Supreme Court said basically, you're all crazy and need to get out of here, they criticized the court for being, well, too moral. Michael Vick may let dogs wrestle in his backyard, and personally I find that a little eerie and creepy and abhorrent myself. But certainly there's a difference between killing children and letting dogs duke it out. When Vick was making his famous rounds of PR a year ago, he was only on the front page of the sports papers for giving his fans the finger. His most recent problems have launched him to the front page of every newspaper in America and the top of the hour news updates on all the major news channels. He would be an attractive candidate to the Democratic ticket, and I think that you Democrats all know it. Kevin McCullough with you next time for the Musclehead Revolution. It's what you want, it's what I am, it's what you make me. Without you, there's no doubt I'd never be anything. I can't foresee what I'll become until you make me.
Wasserhead. It's me, Uncle Mario. You listen now. You listen good. We need some backup, some stronger backup, to keep the revolution rock solid. We gotta get them on board. You know, listening. Come on. Get some from the neighborhood. Go to Bruno's. Get those co-workers. Tell them to tune in to the Musclehead Revolution. Hey, it's not what you do for us. It's what the Musclehead Revolution does for you. I'm sure you understand.